the Gateway quarterback who survived a deadly shooting in North Carolina, breaking his silence. Only on 4, Tommy Woodson talks about the fateful night when he lost his best friend. Channel 4 Action News reporter Marcy Cipriani tonight.
Tommy Woodson tells me Darrell Turner was not just a teammate here on Gateway's football field. He tells me he was like his big brother. And he says he's grateful that he was with him near the end of his life. And he says he'll carry Darrell with him throughout his.
I just don't feel the same. I felt miserable.
For 15-year-old Tommy Woodson, the loss is tough, the support overwhelming, and his own recovery a difficult one.
I got to go to physical therapy.
The gunshot to this Gateway quarterback's right leg has made even walking a struggle. But for Woodson, his injury is mainly a reminder of losing his friend here in Durham, North Carolina. While Woodson was shot in the leg, his teammate and best friend, Darrell Turner, was killed.
Darrell was a person that was filled with excitement, joy, always laughing, smiling, joking around. That was just the type of person he was.
An 18-year-old who lived for football and was heading into his senior year at Gateway High. Turner, Woodson, and a group of other players were in North Carolina touring colleges on their way to a football camp in Florida. Police say the boys were shot after an argument with Gabriel Gomez. Since that moment, Tommy Woodson tells me he has thought of just two things.
Just my leg and how much I miss my friend. That's it, really. If Darrell's looking down on us right now, I just want to let him know that I love him. And I miss him. And I'm praying for his family. And we're going to do this for him.
Gabriel Gomez has been charged with shooting Darrell and Tommy and is expected in court next month. Tommy tells me he will recover physically, but emotionally will be a challenge. In Monroeville, Marcy Cipriani, Channel 4 Action News.
And we have just learned that Gabriel Gomez, the man accused of shooting and killing Darrell Turner, was indicted in North Carolina.